Now we are going to discuss about amino acids. What is amino acid? You people must know and must be aware of its importance. It is basically building block of protein, which is most required macromolecule for growth and development as well as maintenance of our body. Amino acids contain both amino as well as carboxyl functional groups, and structure of alpha amino acids contain NH2CHRCOOH. Here you can see that this molecule contains both NH2 means amino group as well as COOH, that is carboxyl functional groups. And both these functional groups are attached to the same carbon atom known as alpha carbon. These amino acids are classified on several bases. First is depending upon polarity of the functional groups, that is into two groups, polar and non-polar. Polar amino acids mainly contain hydrophilic, that is charged amino acids, that is basically negatively or positively. Under negatively charged amino acids comes aspartic acid and glutamic acid, whereas under positively charged amino acids come all the basic amino acids, that is histidine, lysine and arginine. Second classification is based on side chains, that is organic substituent. And we will discuss all these things in detail. Next basis of classification is nutritional classification. Depending on that nutritional value of amino acids, it is divided into two groups, that is essential as well as non-essential amino acids. There are basically 20 total amino acids, out of which 8 are essential and 2 are semi-essential amino acids. Adequate consumption of amino acids are very essential not only during development and maturation but also in different physiological conditions like pregnancy and lactation, and also during injury like burn, etc. It is required in more amount. Basically, essential amino acids must be present in the food to be utilized properly. And the food or protein source which contains all the essential amino acids are known as complete protein source, whereas incomplete protein source means there is lack of one or more of essential amino acids. Now, we will study about optical property. As you know, there are 20 types of amino acids. One or three letter abbreviations are used to represent amino acid in the peptide linkages. All amino acids have asymmetric carbon atoms. Because of that presence of asymmetric carbon atoms, amino acids are optically active. Exception is glycine, because it doesn't contain asymmetric carbon. Amino acids can be divided into two groups, that is dextrorotatory or levorotatory, depending upon the rotation of plane polarized light. L amino acids represent majority of amino acids found in proteins, that is levorotatory amino acids, whereas dextrorotatory amino acids are produced by exotic sea-dwelling organisms only. Levo and dextro convention for amino acid configuration refers to optical activity of the glyceraldehyde isomer from which the amino acid is synthesized, rather than the optical property of the acid itself. L-glyceraldehyde is levorotatory and D-glyceraldehyde is obviously dextrorotatory. Here you can see the structure of amino acids. In this figure, you can see both functional group, that is carboxylic group as well as amino group, is attached to same carbon atom known as alpha carbon. And levo amino acid and dextro amino acids are a sort of mirror image of each other. Here you can see in this figure, in levo amino acid, amino group is on its left side, whereas in dextro rotatory amino acid, it is on right side. And both of these L and D amino acids are mirror images of each other. Now, what is Jeter ion? At isoelectric point, protonated ammonium groups are deprotonated. At isoelectric point, protonated ammonium groups and deprotonated carboxylate groups are equal, resulting into net neutral charge and formation of Jeter ion. That is, there is no negative or positive charge, there is neutral charge on the molecule known as Jeter ion. Jeter ion can behave as both as a base as well as an acid. For glycine, an isoelectric point is arithmetic mean of the two pKa values because of absence of an ionizable group in its side chain. Glycine has a net negative charge at pH more than isoelectric point, and it will move towards the anode, whereas at pH lesser than isoelectric point, glycine has a net positive charge, and in that condition, it will obviously move towards the cathode. Here you can see classification of amino acids specifically based on polarity. I already told you in the beginning that based on polarity, amino acids are grouped into two groups, that is polar and non-polar, whereas depending upon side chain, it is divided into acidic, basic, aliphatic, aromatic, or sulfur containing amino acids specifically based on R group properties. Here you can see polar amino acids contain aspartic acid and glutamic acid, which is negatively charged, whereas positively charged amino acids, that is basic amino acids, arginine and lysine, also comes under polar amino acid group. Even neutral amino acids contain asparagine, serine, cysteine, glycine, and threonine, histidine, tyrosine, and glycine also comes under neutral amino acid, whereas non-polar amino acid includes alanine, valine, isoleucine, leucine, methionine, phenylalanine, proline, and tryptophan. Now we will see each and every amino acids depending upon its side chain, nature of the side chain. First group is amino acids containing aliphatic side chains. Under that comes five amino acids, that is glycine. Here you can see there is only hydrogen molecule, but whereas in alanine, also there is methyl group attached to alpha carbon. Similarly, in valine, also there is aliphatic side chain, leucine, aliphatic side chain. Even in case of isoleucine, there is aliphatic side chain. Now comes amino acid side chains with sulfur atoms. Under that group comes methionine, which contains sulfur, as well as cysteine, which also contains sulfatyl group. Next group comes amino acid side chains containing hydroxylic groups. Under that group comes serine. It also contains hydroxyl group, threonine containing OH group, and tyrosine, which also contains hydroxyl group. Next group comes amino acids with aromatic rings. Here you can see phenylalanine containing aromatic rings, tryptophan containing aromatic rings, proline, tyrosine, as well as histidine amino acids containing aromatic rings. Now comes amino acid side chain with basic groups. Here you can see lysine contains another amino group other than basic functional group, that is NH3. Similarly, arginine also contains extra basic group, and histidine also contains NH. Thus, all these three amino acids come under basic group of amino acids. Now comes amino acid side chains with acidic groups or their amides. Here, in case of aspartic acid and glutamic acid, you will see acidic groups other than the basic functional groups. Whereas, in case of aspargine and glutamine, there are amide groups along with functional group of amine and carboxylic group. Thus, we have seen that amino acids are divided based on structure of side chain as well as polarity. Other than this, even amino acids are classified on the basis of nutritional importance into two groups, that is essential and non-essential amino acids. As you have already seen, we have discussed that through foods, essential amino acids, you can remember it like VIL-MPTT. V stands for valine, I for isoleucine, L for leucine, L for lysine, MPTT. M stands for methylalanine, P for phenyl, M stands for methionine, P for phenylalanine, T for threonine, and T for tryptophan. And there are two semi-essential amino acids, namely arginine and histidine, which may be required to be supplied through food sometimes because they are not always synthesized from another nitrogen sources. That's all about amino acids. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.